Hi, good morning. Welcome to SSV AIT classes. I am Basha, faculty of yours. 8th class analytical geometry. In previous class, we discussed about the congruency of lines. What is a congruency of lines? Means two or more lines intersecting at a point. Then the point is known as point of congruence, and the lines are said to be concurrent lines. So there are so many concurrent lines in our geometry. Especially in a triangle, we will get the intersection of medians, altitudes, perpendicular bisectors, and internal angular bisectors, and external angular bisectors. So many concurrent lines we have. So now we are going to discuss about the medians in a triangle are concurrent. Means, what is a median? Median means a line segment which is drawn from vertex to midpoint of a opposite side. ABC is a triangle where AD is the median, D is the midpoint of BC. Similarly, E is the midpoint of AC. F is the midpoint of AB. B, C, F. AD, B, C, F are the medians. Then they are intersecting at a point which is known as centroid. Means here, point of congruence is centroid. Here, the three lines are, line segments are intersecting at one point. They are concurrent or not, what is the condition? We will find here. Let us A x1 by 1, B x2 by 2, C x3 by 3. Then these are the vertices of a triangle. Then A, B, C are the vertices and D, E, F are the midpoints. Are the midpoints of the three sides of a triangle. Then how to find the congruency means, already we discussed in previous video, P into L1 plus Q into L2 plus R into L3 is equal to 0, where P, Q, R are the any three real values. By using that condition, here we are proving three lines. We are finding the equation of AD, BE, CF. Means we know A vertex coordinates and we want to find the D coordinates. Means D is equal to midpoint of BC. So midpoint formula, x1 plus x2 by 2, means here we have x2 plus x3 by 2, y2 plus y3 by 2. This is the coordinates of D. Means we know two points on the line AD line. We are finding the equation of AD, A, D. We know two points. Equation of a line which passing through two points is known as y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, where m is the slope of line AD. So if we don't know the slope, by using the two vertices y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 formula, we will find the slope of the AD line. Means equation of AD line or line segment. So then y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Already we know x1, y1 points, so that's why I wrote here x1, y1. Y minus y1 is equal to m, slope means AD slope, AD, x2, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, means here also we will get y1 minus y2 plus y3 by 2, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, which is x2, x here, x1 minus x2 means x2 plus x3 by 2. This is m into x minus x1. By taking 2 LCM in numerator and denominator, then we will get the condition y minus y1 is equal to 2y1 minus y2 minus y3 by 2. Here also 2x1 minus x2 minus x3 into x minus x1. Then transporting the denominator to LHS side, y minus y1 into, we will get 2x1 minus x2 minus x3. That is equal to 2y1 minus y2 minus y3 into x minus x1. Then This is the equation. By transporting any one of the sides, you will get the x minus x1 into 2y1 minus y2 minus y3 minus, I am writing this one, y minus y1 into 2x1 minus x2 minus x3 is equal to 0. Equation 1, which gives us AD line. Equation of AD line. Observe AD. AD. We will find the median of BCD gives, and AD means this is the x1, y1. Observe, we are finding AD means it is in the form of 1, 1, 1, 1. Similarly, it is the equation of AD line or line segment. Similarly, we will find the equation of BE. BE line. Equation of BE line. So B means x2 y2 we will get. By using this condition, same. By using this proforma, we will find, I am writing directly, BE means B x minus x2. Instead of x1, I am writing x2. Here, 2 y2 minus y1 minus y3. 2 2 minus y2. Here, 2x2 minus x1 minus x3 is equal to 0. Equation number 2, which gives us BE line. Observe, here we have 1 1 place, we are keeping 2 2. Remaining, if it is 2 means remaining 1 3. 1 3, 1 3. So, BE line after CF line. CF line. CF line means third vertex x minus x3. 2 y3 minus 3 means 1, 2. Y1 minus y2 remaining coordinates. Y minus y3, 3 means here also 3. 2 x3 minus x1 minus x2. That is equal to equation number 3. So already we denoted it is as identically L1, it is as L2, it is as L3. If we know L1 and L2, L3 lines, there is a condition for the three lines are concurrent where PL1 plus QL2 plus RL3 is equal to 0. Means where P is equal to Q is equal to R is equal to 1. From here, if we make these real values are 1, then it will become 1 into L1, 1 into L2, 1 into L3 is equal to 0. So then we will get 0 compulsory by adding these three equations. Then we can say that the medians in a triangle are concurrent based on this condition. Already we proved this condition in previous video. So by using these statements we can prove here medians here. Now we are going to find the altitudes in a triangle are concurrent. What is a altitude? ABC is a triangle where x1 y1, x2 y2, x3 y3 are the vertices. Altitude, which is known as a line segment which is drawn from vertex to perpendicular to the opposite side, is known as a altitude. We have three altitudes in a triangle: AD, BE, CF. So these are the three altitudes. How to find? Similarly, what we discussed in this session, we are finding the AD, CF equations. Then by adding the three, by using this condition, we will get equal to 0. Then they are concurrent. Already we have proved in medians. So I am finding the median, but here D is not a midpoint. So here we have a condition: BC perpendicular to AD, BC perpendicular to AD, and also AC perpendicular to BE, and also AB perpendicular to CF. So these are the perpendicular lines. Means already we know the angular inclination of an angle, which are two perpendicular lines, then their product of their slopes is equal to minus 1. M1, M2 is equal to minus 1. If we find the slope of BC, BC slope, already we know y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, then making it is equal to minus 1, M1, M2 is equal to minus 1, we will get M2. M2 is equal to minus 1 by M1. So by using this identity, we will find the slope of AD. Then after finding slope, by substituting the formula, slope intercept form, what we will get here? y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Already we know slope means by substituting in this equation we will get the AD line. So ABC slope is equal to so y3 minus y2 by x3 minus x2, BC slope. So which is perpendicular to AD means AD slope is equal to which is known as m1. AD slope is equal to m2. M2 is equal to minus 1 by m1. Already we wrote here minus 1 by m1. That is equal to minus 1 by y3 minus y2 by x3 minus x2. Then it will become minus of x3 minus x2 by y3 minus y2. Then it will be written as x2 minus x3 by, or we can keep like that only, y3 minus y2. This is the slope of AD. Means equation of AD, is equal to y minus y1 is equal to m2 into x minus x1. So which was passing through A, means I am substituting x1 y1 values here, y1 x1. AD slope means AD slope already wrote here, y minus y1 is equal to m2 value x2 minus x3 by y3 minus y2 into x minus x1. So by substituting here y minus y1 into y3 minus y2, that is equal to x minus x1 into x2 minus x3. So by arranging it in one side, x minus x1 x2 minus x3 is equal to y minus y1 y3 minus y2 is equal to 0, which gives us L1 or equation 1. Similarly, what we find here, equation of AD, then we will find the BE, CF values also by using first AC slope and which is perpendicular BE, BE slope, then equation of BE. And again AB slope which is perpendicular to CF, then we will get CF slope by using equation of CF. Then similarly, equation of, it is equation of AD, AD line equation. So then I am finding here BE, line equation. Observe, BE is what, x2, y2. Instead of x1, y1, we are substituting x2, y2. That's x minus x2. Means here 2 we have. Means here we get 1 and 3. Means 1, 2, 3. Here we have x3 minus x1 minus y minus y2. Here we will get 1 after 3. Means we will get 2 after 1 minus y3 is equal to 0, identically L1. Then CF line, equation of CF, x minus x3 x1 minus x2 minus y minus y3 y2 minus y1, that is equal to 0, which gives us L2 and L3. These are the equations 1, 2, 3 and L1, L2, L3. By using this condition, P of L1 plus Q of L2 plus R of L3 is equal to 0, where P is equal to Q is equal to R is equal to 1, then 1 into L1, 1 into L2 plus 1 into L3 is equal to 0, which gives us, by adding these three equations definitely we will get 0. By using this condition we can say the intersection of altitudes in a triangle are concurrent. In previous case, the intersection of medians in a triangle are concurrent. Means in a triangle, medians, altitudes, perpendicular bisectors, internal angular bisectors and external, one internal and two external angular bisectors which are concurrent at a point. Concurrent means intersecting at a point. So next one, the last one is, already in previous case, class we discussed about the concurrence of three straight lines, which was in last topic in our syllabus, the additional topic. The concurrent of three lines L1, which gives us A1x plus B1y plus C1, A2x, L2, L3. Already we have standard form of these three lines. If these three are congruent, we will find the determinant of the coefficients of x, y constant, means a1, a2, a3, b1, or we can write a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3. This determinant value is equal to 0. Already we will discuss this determinant value, how to find in matrices. Means by taking this as positive sign, negative sign, positive sign. By finding the determinant of 3x3 matrix, if we will get 0 is as a result, then the three straight lines are concurrent. And we have some more examples on concurrent of lines in our syllabus. So based on these conditions and formulas, we will prove the given three lines are concurrent. Thank you.